The creative arts often spark thought and reflection of our everyday lives. Street artists bring this concept to a higher level by using the physical world as their canvas. In Buffalo, respected artist, musician, and educator Edreys Wajed has been creating murals across the city. Most notable is the Freedom Wall, a commissioned public work located in the city's African-American Heritage Corridor. Claudine Ewing from WGRZ-TV introduces us to this inspiring artist.
Did you ever think as a kid growing up in Buffalo that public art, you know, this used to be called graffiti, get it off my wall, get it, don't put that on my building. But now you have public art, these murals, they tell a story, they're lasting. Did you ever think that you would have a hand in something that would be lasting in the city of Buffalo?
Never, I did not. And so now, given that we have permission as artists, like we have permission, and we have platform, and we have support.
The Freedom Wall, there are several artists who participated. How many did you paint on that
wall? So there are four artists altogether, and there are 28 portraits, so each of us were responsible for seven.
Which one was your favorite?
Oh. Well, I'll tell you the one that I cried in front of. I cried in front of Malcolm X. And I was very nervous about doing it, you know. And I was, you know, always questioning, am I really capable? Did they make the right selection? Did I make the right choice of saying yes? And then right when I got to Malcolm X, it just put everything into perspective for me about somebody who actually had real fears that came to fruition. Like, he put his life on the line for something. And me creating that artwork wasn't me putting my life on the line. You know, like, so in comparison to, it's like, you can do this, you got this, you know? And so that's when I had a breakdown there and just was crying, like, in gratitude, though. Like, it's just in gratitude for the opportunity. Gratitude for saying yes, and gratitude for being courageous enough to just, you know, let go of my worries and my self-critique of, you know, whether I'm good enough. And Harriet Tubman was another one of my favorite, too. She was the seventh of the seven.
That's unbelievable.
Yeah.
Especially at that time, the movie was getting ready to happen, and so people who hadn't known came to know who's Harriet Tubman, and here you are painting about the Black Moses.
Yeah, Black Moses. Yeah, yeah. That was a rich piece for me, for her to close it out. And in the middle of painting that, we had a solar eclipse that day. We had a solar eclipse, which made it even more special to me because she navigated by the stars, you know? So it just was like, I sat down during that time and just reflected and, like, again, just reminded, like, I'm supposed to be here.
Isn't that what civil rights, though, is all about? It's about opportunity, it's about courage, it's about all of this.
Yes, and awareness. Yeah. It's about awareness, it's about creating awareness. And so messages, particularly like this one, it's just a deeper read into making people thoughtful, you know, going beyond and looking further down the line. Like, love Black girls is a statement in itself. Even when they become women is a longer conversation, because now we're talking about the lifespan, you know, of a child, because we're going to grow, you know, children will grow. That's what we do. We have to evolve.
Do you think Martin Luther King would like that? Because he always talked about his four little children, Black boys, Black girls, and look at what we have.
Oh my goodness, I would really like to think this is in line with the work and his walk, you know, and what he spoke about, for sure. Because I mean, in one of his most famous speeches, he talks about little boys and girls playing together, little boys and white girls, little Black boys and Black, like, playing together. This is a part of it. You know, this is a part of it, and acknowledging them and seeing them, you know?